The Larra before is the achiever type of person. Everybody calls her pretty, and she was trying to carve her place in the world even when she was still young. But despite that, she was also this very shy and insecure girl. People call me the girl on fire, but I'd like to believe that I am more than that. I was in a fiesta and there was power outage and I had to answer the call of nature. I didn't have any source of light that time. I didn't have flashlight or a phone to light up the way. And I had to answer the call of nature, so I had to bring a candle with me. And my cousin Jam volunteered to be with me. And so this is the dining area where the adults were cooking food for the fiesta. And this is exactly where the LPG was located that we didn't know was leaking. There was. And as we got in the comfort room, the fire from the candle got caught with a leak from the LPG. The entire comfort room blew up and we got trapped inside the burning comfort room. I remember seeing flames everywhere and screaming and banging the door, and I remember dipping my head in the bucket of water to alleviate the pain. We were in the hospital for 2 months, underwent 9 operations under general anesthesia, suffered second and third degree burns on 46% of my body. Throughout the entirety of being treated for the physical burns, it was really painful. Like being in an operating room, getting your skin stripped open for bandages. I would scream and cry for hours on end. First time knowing that my dad cried, it broke my heart. Because I never saw my dad cry. He was this pillar of strength. My mom too. Just thinking about it now, how much they had to endure. It was heartbreaking. I think that was the hardest part of my recovery. Turns out everybody else got burnt too. Mine just happened to be the physical fire. Everyone else's fire was invisible, but we all did. We all went through the fire. And not really too fast to recover, but maybe I skipped some parts of the recovery, such as the grieving part, the why did it have to be me part, the crying about what I lost, battling with existential questions such as what if it didn't happen. The insecurity that I had before was doubled, even tripled, because I was covered with scars, and I thought that kind of partly, not entirely, defined me, but it was a huge chunk of my identity, the scars. What was inside my head was that when people saw me, they would think about my scars, and the rest of Larra would go away. The scars would define me when I talk to people, when I meet new people, and that's all that there is to Larra, when in fact there is so much more to me than just that. For the next 7 years, what I did was hide from the world, covering myself with masks and cardigans. And I didn't know that hiding from the world meant me hiding from myself. Bundles of flowers away through the hours of cold. It was so difficult because when you hide from yourself, you kind of like reject yourself first before everybody else rejects you. Those hurtful things that I assumed other people were thinking of me were the things that I thought about myself. And you have to be on your side, right? You can't be against you. So I started accepting me for me. My scars just happen to be visible. Majority of other people's aren't. As what my mom says, you know, we all have fires, Jude. We all struggle with different fires. Knowing that, it made me not take things for granted, you know what I mean? And yeah, it made me not question my existence anymore. It makes me so grateful for waking up in the morning.
The appreciation for life. It's the appreciation for the mundane, the small. That after all, it's not so small.
Even like looking at my mom and my dad like in the dining room, I get so mushy and scenty. It's like, ah, thank you for the chance to live another day. Maybe. Just maybe. It was awakening, I'd say. And it's the kind of awakening that you want to share to other people, that you aren't tied to your physicality only, that you are not defined by the externalities. It's been said again and again for years that a person's identity or worth doesn't really stem from what is seen on the outside. Someone told me that I'm more than a face, and that's maybe that applies to more than just the face. I am more than my scars. I am more than what I think defines me. There's so much more to a person than the worldly standards of what a person should be. Whatever it is that you think defines you, you are more than that. I've become the phoenix who rose from the ashes of life's fires. I now know that whatever comes my way, I can battle it, I can handle it, and I can come out of it brighter than before. And the light that I have come to have, I will share to other people. I really pray for a world where people finally become the phoenixes from the ashes of their fires. Like, bro, let's heal together.
Bundles of flowers away through the hours of cold. Winter shall howl at the walls, tearing down doors of time.